Okay, let me talk about how to use the shader filter. Let me show you where I download it. Simply open up a browser. I can't see myself. Move it up. And let's get there. Type OBS shader plugin. Okay, and then enter. Then you will see this OBS shader filter website. Click inside. Then you will see here the GitHub link beside source code URL. Click it. Once you get in GitHub, you will see here and click clone and download. I won't download as I got it already. After your download, get back to, usually it will go to your download folder. Should be here. Oops, my phone is off. The download folder should be here. If you didn't specify, it will go to your download folder. Okay, leave it like this. Then you should see a folder called OBS Shader Filter. Window, I assume you're using Windows. It's a zip file. You need to extract it. Here I've just extract. So you should see the folder here. Just click inside and you should see all these files. What you need to do is copy and paste these OBS shader folder by pressing Ctrl C and then put it inside your OBS installation folder here. My OBS folder is in D drive, program files. That's my setup. Your setup might be different from mine. Bear in mind, it has to be in OBS folder. So it should be in OBS studio folder. Okay, and then paste the OBS shader filter folder to the data folder inside the OBS studio folder's data folder, and then plugins, and then paste it here. So you should see OBS shader filter win here. Click inside and you will see all the folders that we extract before. Let's see. That's the installation. Once you get that done, you can now turn it off and then go to your video source. Then click filters to get into the video filters panel. Here, let me remove my original filters. And add a new shader filter. For a name, just name it whatever you want. Once you get it done, simply left click the filter. You can either code your effect here or select from the default effects. Make sure you tick both of them for effects, then hit browse and navigate to the OBS Studio Data, OBS Plugins, Shader Filter -win, OBS Shader Filter -win, Data, OBS Plugins, OBS Shader Filter Examples folder, and look for those ending with dot effect. Here I pick the cartoon effect, and here it's the preview. And this is the actual result. Let's say if I want to use a dot shader instead of an effect, let me untick everything and only keep the bottom one. Simply hit browse and look for files ending with dot shader. Here you can preview the blinking shader. The blink is too slow, so let me make it a little bit faster. Here you'll see the speed item. If I change it to 100, you'll see a much quicker blink.